Hey everybody, welcome in. My name is Ernest and I'm gonna teach you how to cook. Summer is still upon us and one of the best things to snack on in the summertime are chicken wings. And that's what I'm making for you today. It's a nice sriracha wing, but it's actually a glaze. It's not just a thick goopy sauce put on there. It's incredibly easy to make, very addictive, so you might be careful with this. And what's a wing or an order of wings without blue cheese dressing? That's what I'm going to show you in the extra helping. Dressings are so easy to make and so much more tasty than anything you can buy in the store. So let's get going. Summer is still here and I've got some wings and some sriracha and an empty tummy. So let's get going. This is Eating in Bed. You know, I have to admit, I really wasn't a huge fan of wings. I didn't hate them. I just think they weren't on my radar until the past 20 years. When I moved here to New York, you know, the home of buffalo wings, they were created in Buffalo, New York. They quickly got on my radar and I think I'm in love. They're great. There's all different kinds. I love a teriyaki wing. I love just a hot wing, but not too hot. I love a barbecue wing, all kinds of good stuff. All kinds of good stuff out there, but I'm gonna show you one today. Wings you can really make any time of year, you know, whether it's baseball season, football season, basketball season, somebody's watching the game and somebody needs a snack or snack. And I'm gonna show you how to do that today. This is really an easy dish to do. It's very addictive, like I said in the intro. So you might wanna double up on this recipe. Now there's a trick if you double or quadruple the recipe. So I'm gonna tell you that in a little bit, but let me show you what we're doing here. We're going to make our marinate and everything that we need for it in this container. It's a 9x13 dish and you're gonna marinate in this and you're going to cook in this. So it's perfect. You don't need to mess up anything else. The next thing that is going to get messed up after this is probably anywhere in this region from eating it. Now I've got a few things here, but let me set some things to the side. They're really simple, small ingredients in this. I'm gonna start with ginger for a reason, because ginger is one of those things where people are a little confused by it. And to tell you the truth, I'm not a fan of ginger. It's very harsh, it's very spicy. But when you cook ginger, it gets nice and soft. You actually need about a tablespoon of fresh ginger, and this is probably gonna yield that, but it has this skin on it, this fibrous skin, and you don't wanna eat that. The best way to peel ginger, you can do it with a knife if you want to, but if you just use a spoon, because it's got a thin edge, not a thick spoon, this is just like a soup spoon, just take it and you can peel it, look at that, right along the side, and just take all that skin off. Just like that. Oh, there's the smell of ginger. You know, we were actually vegan or vegetarian for a while, a few years ago, and I put a lot of ginger in smoothies because I would have smoothies in the day and then a regular, you know, vegan meal or something in the evening. And I always looked up good vegan recipes, and I tell you, there's so many vegan recipes that have ginger in them. I'm not gagging on it or anything, but it's not the greatest in the world. And on the side of this right here, there's a little bump that I can just kind of take off carefully with a knife. There you go, and get rid of that. So you can usually chop ginger. If you're doing something in a food processor, you can put it in there as well, but I'm actually gonna grate it. I have my microplane. These are really great. I'll put the link in the description or the caption below. And this is one I got on Amazon. It was really inexpensive and it really is nice. And you can grate ginger. Ginger's kind of fibery. You can see the fibers in it right there possibly, but I'm just gonna grate it right into the dish. Sometimes it can be a little bit more fibery like this. Sometimes it can be a little bit juicier. So either way, you know, you're going for the overall flavor. That's about a tablespoon. Right there, it doesn't take much. That's how you do ginger. Now the rest of this is super, super easy. Let me show you where we're starting. We're starting with some soy sauce right here. I'm gonna need 1/4 cup of soy sauce. So I'm just gonna measure out right here. 1/4 cup is 4 tablespoons, so it's not much. right in the dish. Not a lot in there. I know this doesn't look really great right now, but trust me, it gets better. So next to this, I'm gonna add 2 tablespoons of apple cider vinegar and 1 teaspoon of white vinegar. Ultimately, you need 2 tablespoons and 1 teaspoon of vinegar right in your dish, just like that. And then 1 to 2 tablespoons of sriracha sauce, a good tablespoon, maybe a slight bit heaping. This obviously is gonna add the flavor. Now you're thinking, Ernest, that's not a lot of sriracha for all the wings you're gonna do. You're right. But I'm gonna tell you why it's more than enough in a minute here. Now we need some sugar. I got 1.5 teaspoons each of brown sugar and white sugar. You can do all brown sugar. I like a combination of both. So 1.5 teaspoons each of white sugar and brown sugar. And then 1.5 teaspoons of toasted sesame oil. Almost didn't get it out. Toasted sesame oil is the kind you flavor with. It comes in the small bottle like this. It's not what you would cook in, it's what you flavor with. You need 1.5 teaspoons of that. This is a 1/2 teaspoon measurement, so I'm gonna do 3 of these to give myself, well, that's probably about 1.5 teaspoons. I'm gonna do a little bit more, there we go. The toasted is very different, that's what you want, and you can find this on the aisle at any grocery store. If you want to, you can go to an Asian market. There's probably tons of variety and choice there for you as well. And lastly, I just need a clove of garlic. This one is actually pretty big. I don't know if I'm gonna get the whole thing in there or not, but break it in half and just press it. You can mince this if you want to. I really love the garlic press for the reasons of it just being faster. And that is your marinade. Oh yeah, it's that easy. I told you it was easy. So we're gonna whisk all this around though. And we're doing this right in this, I have a 9x13 dish here, and this is important for reasons that I will tell you in a minute. Okay, so everything's nice and mixed. Here's the thing about doubling this menu. You can double the recipe that you just saw here, including the wings that I'm gonna show you in a minute, the amount of wings. You can double it, you can quadruple it, very easy to do. But you only need to do what I showed you in the recipe today per dish. If you doubled this up and still put it in a 9x13, it's going to be very wet and not get the final result or anywhere close to that that you want. So for every portion of recipe that you see here that I've done today, the 1/4 cup of soy sauce, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera, use a different dish. You can use an 11x13, you can use an 8x10, or I'm sorry, 11x14, I think it is. An 8x10 dish, this is a 9x13. Let's get the wings in here. This is 1.5 pounds of chicken wings. Now chicken wings usually come frozen. There's a lot of frost on them, they have a lot of water in them, and it'll get really kind of wet in your marinade, and you don't want that. So what I do is I measured out 1.5 pounds, and I put them on this rack that you see here, and I put it in a bigger dish like this, uncovered in the bottom of my fridge, and let them totally thaw. Why did you leave it uncovered? Well, because if it's uncovered, the cool air in your fridge is going to dry out the skin, and that makes it nice and crispy. Now, last night before I went to bed, I put a little bit of salt on either side. That helped draw the final bits of moisture out. And I had probably 2 to 3 tablespoons of water and moisture that came off of these wings. So they're a little bit drier now. They're nice and pliable. They're nice and thawed. This is 1.5 pounds. I'm gonna put these right in my marinade. I've got the drumettes and the little wing section, which if you didn't know, this is part of the wing, oh, with a big piece of skin. This is part of the wing and it attaches to the drumette. That's kind of all one piece and you snap it apart and you have this little, this is actually the joint that goes to the body. It looks like a little chicken leg, but it's actually part of the chicken wing. So we're gonna put all these in here. So I put them in here, I'm gonna turn them over so they're both coated, but you're only gonna marinate this about 30 minutes. You could do this overnight if you wanted to, but I really don't see the need for it. So we're gonna marinate these for 30 minutes. Halfway through at the 15-minute mark, turn them back over again so both sides are kind of setting in the marinade for a while. When we come back, it'll be 30 minutes later, and then we're gonna get these in the oven. Okay, so it's been 30 minutes. I have turned these over halfway through. As you can see, they are ready to go in the oven right now. But yeah, just it, 30 minutes is all you need. Wings aren't really that big to do a lot of marinating with, so I'm not worried about it. So these are gonna go into a preheated 375 degree oven, 20 to 25 minutes. All of this liquid around here is going to cook off. And when you're done, it's gonna be nice and, you know, there's that sugar and everything in there. It's gonna get nice and sticky, and we're gonna rub the wings in it as we pull them out of there to get some of that on, and we're gonna try some of it. Now look, stay tuned, because in the extra helping, what goes better with wings than blue cheese dressing? There's so many dressings that you can make on your own that are so much better than buying them out of the store, and blue cheese is really one of those. So we're gonna take a break. I'm gonna show you how to do the blue cheese dressing when we come back. It's gonna be about 20, 25 minutes later. These wings are gonna be done. It's a beautiful day. Stay tuned. I will see you right after this. Tabs got sass. Ooh, you're gonna love it. Sassy, crisp, tasty, you've been thirsting for. Tabs got sass. Can't get enough of it. Not too sweet, just one little calorie. Tabs got sass. Ooh, you're gonna love it. A sassy, crisp taste you've been thirsting for. That refreshing and satisfying taste. Tabs not too sweet. Tabs got sass. Ooh, you're gonna love it. A sassy, crisp taste. In a large glass measuring cup, add 1 cup of buttermilk. You can also use whole milk. To that, add 1/2 cup of Greek yogurt, low fat or non-fat, and 1/2 cup of good mayonnaise. Just add the yogurt and the mayonnaise until it comes up to 2 cups on the side of your measuring container. Gently whisk that together so it's blended well. To that, add 1 tablespoon of fresh chopped thyme and 2 tablespoons of fresh squeezed lemon juice. Whisk all of that together. Transfer that mixture to a larger bowl. Next, crumble 8 ounces by weight of your favorite blue cheese into the mix. You can use Roquefort, Stilton, or Gorgonzola. Add 1/4 teaspoon each of fresh ground black pepper and kosher salt. You can use a spatula, a spoon, or a whisk to help break up the blue cheese. Mix it into the dressing completely until it's combined. Taste for salt and pepper. Store it in the fridge at least 1 hour. Transfer it to a nice bowl for serving. When you're ready to serve, crumble some extra blue cheese on top. And that is simple blue cheese dressing. It's delicious. Enjoy. Okay, it has been 25, 30 minutes. If you feel you need to go a little bit longer because ovens can vary and the water in the chicken can vary, don't be afraid to let it go a little bit longer. You really want most of that sauce to disappear. You may have a little bit of marinade still on there. That's okay, it's totally up to you, but let's take a look at these wings. Oh my God. I mean, really? Look at this. Now look, the sauce is really thickened up. It's nice, it's kind of, there's still a little bit right in the middle, but I'm not so worried about that. Look at that, it's nice and thick. The glaze is light, it's not super heavy or sticky. You could cook this down a little bit more if you wanted to, actually. But this is not bad the way it is. Oh. Now, you really should wait a little bit to eat one of these, but I don't know if I can do that, so I'm gonna try to give it a try here. But look, that's really, the sauce. Let me just taste the sauce. You can taste the sriracha. There's a little bit of heat. It doesn't feel like direct heat. It's kind of on the back of your throat. It's a little bit salty from the soy sauce, of course. A little bit sweet. Oh, that's really nice. Oh, that's good. Oh, so much sauce in the beard. Okay, so I gotta let these cool down to eat them. That's really nice. Look, keep an eye on it so your ginger doesn't burn. It's really dark here around the edges, but it's really not, I mean, it doesn't have a burnt flavor. When this cooks down a little bit more and it's a little thicker, you wanna take your wings and kind of roll it around in the pan and pick up some of that glaze when you pull them out. See how the glaze kind of piles up nicely right there? Do the same with the rest. You don't wanna just pull them out and eat them. I did, because there was a little bit of glaze on them, but kind of roll them around in this because that marinate creates the glaze. Mm. Lord have mercy. And with that blue cheese dressing, I can't wait. So I'm going to get going and I'm going to eat this before my roommate gets home because he loves him some wings too. If you enjoyed the video, if you love wings, which who doesn't? Hello. Give the video a thumbs up. Click the like button. Hit subscribe if you haven't already. There's a new recipe every Friday right on this channel, plus a lot of other good stuff as well. Check the social media in the caption below the recipe. You can find us online. Leave a comment. Let me know what your favorite kind of wing is. I have an orange glazed chicken that I'm doing. It'd make a great wing recipe. I might translate it into a wing recipe, so we might be seeing that again soon. I don't know. But thanks for watching. I'm gonna go have me some wings. I appreciate it. See you later. Bye.